In rectilinear incompressible flow, your velocity is constant and finite. When we move to radial flow, this changes. The velocity is not constant anymore, and even worse, blows up in the origin. So why is that? That is what you will learn in this video. So when you have, for example, radial flow, if you have some cylindrical pipe, you're injecting like water through it, and then you allow the water at the end to flow in the radial direction away from the pipe. So what you would have in that case is that your velocity V is only in the radial direction, so pointing away from the axis like that. And the size of the velocity only depends on R, only depends on the distance of the origin. So for example, if you're close to origin, you could have a bigger velocity than when you are a bit further away. But if you are at an equal distance, say here and there from the origin, velocity is the same in size, only pointing in a different direction, but always in the radial direction. So what happens if you try to find an equation for the velocity in this case? Well, if you have incompressible flow, then you have divergent V equals zero. You can convert this to cylindrical coordinates. Well, that's easy now because you assume only flow in the radial direction, only depending on R. So derivatives with respect to theta and z disappear, components in theta and z direction disappear. So from this divergent V equals zero, you have only one term on this one, and 1 over R, the ddr of R times V equals zero. Well, you can solve that equation. That means that the ddr of R times V equals zero. So R times V has to be equal to a constant. So your solution V will be some constant divided by R. And then you see something happening. First of all, your velocity depends on R. Well, it's more or less okay. But there's a problem here at R equals zero. So your velocity is blowing up at R equals zero. So what's happening here? Is it due to the mathematics, or maybe due to the physics? So what's going on in the origin? Well, let's take a look. We have to take a look at the flux. Suppose at some time we are at distance r with our flow, and then delta t later our flow is at r plus delta r. So what is the volume change during this time delta t? Well, your delta V equals, should be an H over here. Your delta V equals the H, the height, times the delta A. So it's delta A, that's the difference in area between the two circles. One has radius R plus delta R, the other one radius R. So you have your H over here, times pi times R plus delta R squared minus pi R squared. Then if you compute what this is, R plus delta R squared gives you an R squared, a 2R delta R, and a delta R squared. Well, the delta R will be very small, so you can neglect the delta R squared term. Then the first and last cancel out, and you'll get your delta V equals H times 2 pi R times delta R. Now, if you divide by delta T and take the limit to zero, you get delta V delta T, which is your volumetric flux, phi. Delta V over delta T, take delta T to zero. So then you get your factor H times 2 pi R over here. And your delta R delta T with the limit delta T to zero gives you your V in your radial direction. So your flux phi equals 2 times pi times H times R times V in cubic meter per second. And now you see we had V equals C over R, so V times R is some constant. So that means that this R times V over here is some constant. So in this case we have basically that our flux phi is some constant. So saying that V behaves like constant over R means that you are actually saying that your volumetric flux is some constant. Well, of course it is, because we have incompressible flow. So in fact, this property that V behaves as constant over R is an inherent property from the physics. It's due to the fact that we're looking at volumetric fluxes. So it's no problem, not in physics, not in mathematics. One place where you have to be careful if you're trying to do numerics with this, because your program is not going to like it if you go exactly to r equals 0. So in radio flow, you always have to be careful with your velocity field around r equals 0.